is not working
going through these phases of general.
Good, it's supposed to be.
Because
you're not talking through this. So
it's
I want your volume
six
off.
Months since I attended train the
and
training.
You don't have, you shouldn't have any microphone.
It's been good. About 2 months.
Just your
now
camera.
I'm just doing dog training full time.
Which you really don't need, technically.
It has
actually,
been 8 months. I now train dogs and change lives full time, and I couldn't be happier.
It's been less than a year now. I'm training dogs full time, making about $12,000 a month, more than I used to make in a year in my last job.
I'm building a successful business of doing what I love.
If you've always dreamed of being in control of your life, waking up, working dogs on a daily basis, invest in this.
I am so proud to be part of the T3 family.
AM 790 is your station for talk and business with a powerful weekday lineup. From 6 to 10 a.m., it's the iconic Primus in the Morning program, followed by Chris Platt's unique take on politics. From noon till 3. Dennis Miller, nighttime it's Money Guru Dave Ramsey at 6, followed by Michael Savage and the Savage Nation at 9. Great shows and powerful personalities. It all starts weekday mornings at 6 with Imus on your station for talk and business, AM 790.
Hey guys, it's Jeff. I want to talk to you about peace of mind. There's one phone number that I keep in my phone. East Side Collision Center, 2050 Plainfield Pike, Cranston, Rhode Island, 401-490-9975. The peace of mind that I have, if I ever get into an accident, I can call them up, my truck will be towed to them, and I will get incredible service and repairs done to my vehicle. East Side Collision Center, 30 years in business, family-owned, 401-490-9975.
The following paid program is for entertainment and basic informational purposes only. This advertiser is solely responsible for its content. The views expressed do not necessarily reflect the views of Cumulus Media, WPRV Radio, its management, or its staff.
This is What Would Jeff Do? Canine Training with Jeff Gellman. Call Jeff now at 437-5000 or 1-888-345-0790. What Would Jeff Do? On your station for talking business, AM 790.
Good morning, everybody. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training with my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning on AM 790, talking business around the world. On Solid Canine Training Radio. Good morning, Brett. How are you?
Doing well yourself.
Good. It's been a while since we've been in the studio. We've been on the road, making lives change. Good morning, Linda. How are you?
I'm doing awesome. How are you?
Things are great. Thank you.
Just changing lives on the road. No big deal.
That's it.
It's just a thing we do.
That's a thing we do.
Yeah, we have trash can cameras and we change lives on the
road. Hey, actually, Linda, can you scoot over a little bit more? Okay, we're just trying to, we're in the studio now. We're trying to make sure our camera angles are good. They're looking pretty good. 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790. This is the thing, folks. We're at about 50 questions a week that I get emailed, Facebook messages to me. Your phone is off. Emailed, Facebook questions to me. Phone calls looking for free help. This is what I do. The only way I can answer them is through my free radio show, 888-345-0790. I do Mondays and Wednesday free webinars. Did you know that, Brett? Mondays and Wednesdays, free webinars.
I did. I pay attention.
100-minute webinars. That's my goal. 100 minutes. Has the timing been right on those when I send those in to you?
Close enough.
Good. I'm taking the break to the right time, and you can fiddle with it.
Nothing I can't handle.
Good. Awesome.
And I make sure I put everything up on the podcast, so even if it can't fit on the radio show.
Oh, really?
It's going to be on the podcast anyway.
Do you do the end? Because at the end...
I don't know. I don't keep that part.
You don't keep it, right? That's more like banter.
It is, yeah.
All right, and there's some F-bombs in that, so I know we can't do
sometimes
that.
Sometimes there's some inappropriate language,
right.
Yes.
But on Wednesdays, when we do a Wednesday recording, which goes to you, I really limit my wordage. So if you're looking at me now live online through my webinar, and if you don't know how to do that, everything is social media. This is a live radio show heard at a radio station, and it's also streamed around the world. But folks now can also see me on the internet live. If you want to ask a question online, make sure you do it to admin only, and you do to question or chat. Do not put your question for everybody. The reason is because I try to keep people private. I respect people and their privacy, and sometimes people have questions that they're either embarrassed to ask. But I want you to know, number one, there's so much misinformation out there about dog training, and people are struggling, and the reason why I do so much free content, and we're talking about 2, 4, 6 hours of audio and video free content, Because I'm passionate and I'm really tired of people giving away their dogs for minor behavioral problems. So for folks that are looking for help, I'm giving you lots of ways to get to me. So give me a call at 888-345-0790. We've got some Facebook questions. We've got some email questions. We've got some Twitter questions. And we're also now on Instagram, which is really hard to ask a question on. Instagram is not caught up yet with hyperlinks. But we've got some content that we put up on Instagram that is not seen on our Facebook page. We put up new videos all the time. And the way why I'm doing the self-promotion is this. I'm not doing it to increase my business because this is all free stuff. I'm doing it because a lot of folks out there don't have a dog trainer by them, or they cannot afford a dog trainer. The way we're setting up our do-it-yourself how-to dog training videos is you actually don't need to hire a dog trainer. And then you can actually come to my webinars or my radio show, ask your questions. Oh, I finally confirmed, Linda. Did I give you the dates on those?
On what?
On Germany?
No.
Okay.
I've got to talk dates, all right. But not here.
Well, no, I've got to let my fans know because if you want to hire me.
But I'm just saying.
All right. I will be I'll be close to Mannheim, Germany. I'm doing private only, private one-on-one sessions. And you can private message me or email me. If you're interested, I will be there on the 24th of April, leaving on the 27th of April, Friday to Monday. I'm taking private clients. It's a three-hour training session, and we will go over everything. Anything you want to go over, if anything you need help with, we will do. So, ironically, one of my fans invited me over to Bordeaux, France, which I could jump on a plane and go. But, hey, Linda, in August, we should do another Germany and then Bordeaux trip, just you and me.
Why?
Because I can monetize it, and wouldn't it be nice to go to Bordeaux, France? Okay, forget it.
It would be nice. Right, I just think about the kids.
No, I'm going on my own. Nope, you gave me the answer already.
Can I? Oh, that's fine. Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Maybe like, or actually tell you something.
Okay, sure. Well, you're my wife. Of course you tell me
free
things.
Free Question Friday thing, yes. We should probably pin that to the top of your page because I cannot find it anywhere.
Are you
it's
serious?
Gone. It's just gone.
Okay. So what I'll do is I'm going to pin that to me now, and at the commercial break, I'll pin it so you will not be lost and you'll be able to find it. It's not
it was there. I found it yesterday, but right now I can't.
Well, that's because I put up posts. So you're right.
And I went down.
You're right.
It's just
so
not
when
there.
I do Free Question Friday, since Free Question Friday goes up, I probably put up 7 to 8 more posts.
Yeah.
So you're right. I will pin it. Pinning it is great. Oh, this Sunday I've got a nice group walk with John. You know what else? Free Question Friday doesn't get a lot of play. Maybe I need to start.
I mean, there are 5 or 6 questions there that enough. I'd like
to
address.
I just pinned it, by the way. All right, so refresh your browser, and I pinned it. Thank you so much.
Telling you what to do.
All right. And Linda started up a new company. There were not a lot of advertise on the radio, but there will be a link to her new company on my radio show page as well as my weekly newsletter.
See, I was able to piece all that together via the Facebook and the missteps on the air and
yeah.
stuff. Oh, Jeff, don't say this.
Yeah. This is the thing, though. You're not allowed to be on TV and radio, but theoretically – on social, it's a social media company, so on my Monday webinars, I can scream it loud and clear.
You can.
And on the Wednesday, theoretically, Brett, if we had a way to not have this on the air, but have this on the replay, we could do it.
That would be something you'd want to talk to Joseph Lembo about, I
right.
believe.
Right. So, Joe must be happy with the show.
I would think so.
Yeah. If anybody out there is looking for a bed bug dog, Girl, most of you are familiar with Girl. Girl will be a certified bed bug dog in 6 weeks. And she'll be able to go into, for all my folks that have got hotels, or probably mostly hotels or nursing homes that need a bed bug dog, she will come in and she will sniff and she will be trained on live and dead bed bugs.
You know where there's a lot of bed bugs?
I've stayed at some hotels that have bed bugs.
No. Movie theaters.
Really? So for any of my movie theater owners, let me know. For managers, she will come in and she will be able to signal on them before you spend thousands of dollars on bed bug extermination. So
Wait, I've never heard of that, that you could train dogs. What does that entail?
It's just a scent. It's a scent. So it doesn't make a difference if it's drugs.
Okay, so it's similar. I gotcha.
It's the same training they use for marijuana, cocaine, whatever they are.
Methamphetamine?
Yeah, I'm not really familiar with drugs. They use sniffer dogs for batteries for in prison, from cell phones. So it's the same work. It's literally the exact same training. And why does she do it? Because she gets to play tug. That's it. The reward is tug.
She loves to do
tug. She loves to do tug. So we're going to take a quick break. This is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training with my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning on AM 790, talking business around the world on Solid Canine Training, 888-345-0790.
This is Amy from Moriarty's Fence, the Invisible Fence brand pet safety experts. The Invisible Fence brand...
Yeah, Linda, congratulations on your new venture.
We start training puppies as young as 10 to 12 weeks old, and we also keep pets safe at home, too. The key to our 27 years of success is our customer service and pet training support. Our installed outdoor safety solutions start as low as $7.99 and can be customized for your property. Call 800-225-0808 for a free design and pet consultation visit, or schedule online at MoriartysFence.com. At Moriarty's Fence, we work hard so you can rest easy knowing your pet is safe at home. Moriarty's Fence, 800-225-0808, keeping pets safe since 1986. Moriarty's Fence reminds you to support your local shelter, adopt, volunteer, donate.
Hi, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about the most exciting coffee house in Rhode Island, Seven Stars Bakery. They are local, handmade from scratch, award-winning morning pastries and bread, using local milk, local eggs, and lots of local produce. Locally roasted New Harvest coffee. Trained baristas, they will make espresso for you that will knock your socks off. Whether you're meeting a friend for a delicious cup of coffee, some pastry, or grabbing a loaf of bread for dinner, you will not be disappointed. Family-owned and operated, three great locations, east side of Providence, west side of Providence, and in Rumford Center, Seven Stars Bakery. When it comes to local, they do it best. This is Jeff Gellman from Solid Canine Training. I want to talk to you about the folks at E-Collar Technologies and the incredible products that they make. Many of you have seen my low-level remote collar training videos on YouTube, and I talk about low-level remote collar training on my radio show every week. Well, moving forward in 2014, E-Collar Technologies and the Educator brand remotes will be my preferred brand in my board and train facility, as well as my 10,000-square-foot training facility. The ease of use, the understanding for both the dog and the owner are very important to me. The way we train with our remotes is low-level, pressure on, pressure off, and the folks at E-Collar Technologies understand the needs of both the professional dog trainer as well as the average dog owner. Modern remote collar training does not involve shocking or zapping your dog at all. It is a low-level communication tool. It layers existing training with your dog so that your dog understands what you're asking for. If you're looking for the ultimate in high-level distraction, off-leash training, go to ecollar.com. Freeway laundry. Dirty clothes in, clean clothes out. Pick up and delivery. Oh, yeah, you heard me right. Pick up and delivery. And, yes, I wrote that in all caps because I am shouting it. I don't even want to talk about their four convenient locations with self-serve and drop-off service, the comfy couches, the free Wi-Fi. Just go to freewaylaundry.com. You can learn about their locations, their hours, their prices. But let's not forget, free pickup and delivery. Go to freewaylaundry.com. Hey everyone, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue in Providence. That's losandesri.com. Family owned, family run, the most incredible Peruvian and Bolivian food. They're open 7 days a week. Let me tell you how I start there. Okay, I get the ceviche martini, I get the calamari Bolivian style, and causa la mania is delicious. Linda, I know you love the entrees.
They have some awesome entrees. I love the envuelto de pollo. It is such a great dish. The bisteca andina, which is Peruvian-style steak. And they always have awesome specials, steaks grilled to perfection, and delicious fish dishes.
Back in 30.
We don't even get the menu. We just order off the specials menu.
That's true.
Desserts.
Oh.
Desserts. Dessert.
I love the in-house made tres leches cake. That is my favorite, and the flan is awesome, too.
Both homemade. Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue, losandesri.com. Com.
Water damage from frozen pipes at home or office? For immediate response and repair, call the local Rhode Island company, Lynch's Cleaning and Restoration, 464-8937. That's 464-8937. Immediate response, repairs, and total satisfaction.
Welcome back, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, with my weekly call-in radio show. What would Jeff do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning, AM 790, talking business around the world on Solid Canine Training Radio. Give me a call at 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790. This is the thing, folks. A lot of you guys are asking me for questions, and you're telling me how desperate you are and you want my help. Well, now's the time, 888-345-0790. If you can't make the effort to make a phone call to a radio station to get free advice that actually works, I'm sorry. Stop complaining. You know, you get all these people that, you know, my webinars, I get probably 60, 70 questions on Mondays and Wednesdays. But the radio show is different because you can interact with me and I can ask you pertinent questions that will help me give you even better advice. But so many people are just struggling. I got a call this morning or an email from this morning from someone that's got a dog that every time they open up the door, it bolts and they don't want to get rid of the dog. Why would you get rid of the dog for that when it can be fixed in... You can stop it in 30 seconds, and then if the dog does run out, you could actually get it to come back to you in about less than a week with high levels of distractions. So, guys, it's dog training. Just remember, dog training is yes and no. It's really simple.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
So, I have a friend, and her dog needs remote collar training.
Yes.
But she thinks that her dog won't take to it, or won't abide by it.
She's wrong.
So what do you tell people when they say, oh, my dog is, you know, yeah, so far gone that that's not going to help him?
So let me just thank you for asking me that question.
You're welcome.
Let me just educate the general public out there. Every dog, unless it has a brain tumor, can be trained to do what you want. The problem is it's called the world of living in negativity, which a lot of people do. You look at the world from a negative standpoint, right? And that's from low self-esteem issues, all right? Also being told no by your parents year after year, being told no by your boss, being told no from the people around you. And you're probably around toxic people, so you don't think anything works. But I want your friend to know that she's not alone and your dog absolutely can be trained. And that's the way it is. And the problem is, the ethics of dog training, there's a lot of really bad dog trainers out there. A ton of them. You know, I use remote collars. I use prong collars. Somebody wrote me in saying, in fact, I'm going to answer this on my show. Hopefully they're going to call in. It's on Free Question Friday question. A trainer came over and put a prong collar on my 8-week-old puppy.
Okay, don't ask it.
I won't. Okay, but that's just wrong. And I use prong collars. So, like, every dog trainer is not the same. Just like every lawyer, every baker, every banker, every everything. All right. So I got one more thing to talk. I got a lot of things to talk about here, but I need the public's participation. Is Vanessa? Vanessa's on my thing. She's my German friend.
Hey, Vanessa. How's it going?
Good. She's going to be my host in Germany.
That's awesome.
I know. So, remote collars for everything. Somebody, Greg from eCollar Technology, was nice enough to put up my latest video for remote collars. And somebody put a post saying, first of all, they're all great stuff. It's a great little video of Noche with a remote collar doing all kinds of wonderful things. And somebody put, I wonder if this would work for my dog. Guys, listen to me. Remote collars are great for every dog, for every behavior. All it is a training tool. But let's keep in mind, the remote collar doesn't do the work. The training does the work. The remote collar is a communication tool. So of course it would work. Just like food can work. A collar can work. A leash can work. A clicker can work. They're just tools. But if you took a clicker, and I don't do clicker training, but a clicker is a marker, and I use markers all the time. That's all it is, guys. It's a marker. It's a moment in time when the dog does something correct that is followed up with a reward. We do the exact same thing with the word good. It's the same thing. But you can take a clicker and click it. The dog won't do anything. That's the misinformation out there. You should only clicker train your dog. No, you shouldn't. Guys, we live in an almost scam-like dog training world. I'm sorry. The ethics of dog training is terrible. Sarah from Waynesville, M.O., Missouri? Not Montana. Montana's M.T. Good morning, Sarah.
Hi, Jeff. How are you?
It's Missouri, right?
Missouri, yeah. We came here from Honolulu, so it's been a big change.
Well, what did you think it was going to be?
I don't know. I was hoping it would be just like Honolulu.
Yeah, exactly. That's why there's all these people moving to Missouri. What's your question?
Yeah. I actually sent you a question on Facebook, and I want to say thank you because you responded immediately. But I just wanted information. We just got an eight-week-old corgi.
Yes.
And we had a trainer come, and he recommended the prong collar for her, but I don't know. She went nuts the first night.
Yeah.
We got her with the prong collar, but then yesterday she was okay with it. So I was just wondering if she's too young.
She's too young.
Okay. What age do you recommend?
Well,
I saw some of your videos.
Right. So she's too young to have a prong collar on. I'm really surprised that don't name any names, because I never name names. But this is the thing. And I'm a huge prong collar guy, right?
But, yeah, that's why I thought, I was surprised you said she was too young for it.
Yeah. So remember, okay, let's remember, first of all, that everything I use is a tool, right? So it's just a tool. The issue is, with an 8-week-old dog, I would do 100% food training along with a slip lead, okay?
Okay.
So I don't want your dog to ever eat out of a bowl right now. I only want your dog to eat by training your dog. Now, we're not talking about treats. I do not do treat training. Food training is a resource, though, right? It's like you need to eat, and the only way you're going to eat is by working. And that could be something such as going in your crate, coming out of your crate, coming running over to me, sitting, downing. Waiting, you can do food for everything right now. So, the prong collar, I would wait till your dog is at least 14 weeks old. Okay? Now, the reason is because I've never met a dog, probably less than 12 weeks that I needed to put a prong collar on. And I've worked with, I keep saying 3,000 dogs, but I've been telling that story for 2 years.
Do you know I was thinking that yesterday?
So it's probably more. You know what I mean? But so let's call it thousands of dogs. So I've never used a prong collar on a dog that young. I don't know why. I mean, whatever. Every trainer trains differently. But what are the things you're struggling with? I mean, you should be just doing puppy stuff, such as, okay, I don't care as much about obedience at that age as I do about behavior. So
that actually leads to my next question. Is that we were just trying to find stuff online, but like kind of a timeline of when to introduce, walking on a leash, when to introduce all that kind of stuff.
Right. Okay. So Sarah, let's talk about, this is what I do. My 8-week-old clients, when they come to me at 8 weeks old, my this is what my big goal is, Sarah. How can I save you $4,000 by never sending your dog to a boarding train to me? And I'm serious. That's my goal. So how do we do that? The big things you should be working on is this: going into the crate and coming out of the crate on command, all right? Okay. No whining and crying in the crate. But at 8 weeks old, there's going to be some whining because they're going to have to go potty, but we want to make sure that's potty whining, not manipulative whining, all right? Okay. Is your dog going into a crate? You're crating your dog at night and when you leave?
Yes, and during, if we leave, he's got like a pen. It's not as small as the crate, but enclosed area.
I want that dog in a crate, Sarah.
Okay. So crate all the time.
Crate all the time when you're gone. You can still have that little pen area if you're maybe don't have your eyes on the dog. But this is the thing. We work dogs out of the crate, so when they go in the crate, they're so tired they just fall asleep, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Because I also want the dog to be able to learn what the crate is and not have separation anxiety and not freak out. So, and how long can your dog go through the night without having to get up to go to the bathroom?
Oh, I mean, it was amazing. The first night we got her, she slept till 6 in the morning.
What?
I'm like, yeah.
Did you sniff the blood?
I was waiting for it to change, but it, you know, and it's been for 5 nights now. She slept the whole night.
Oh, my gosh. You scored.
Yeah.
Are you smelling the blanket? Are you sure there's no pee?
No. It's everything's, you know, has been clean in there so far.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, good. So that's amazing. I'm amazed by that. So what you want to do is you want to do everything by schedule. So you want to do something called kennel up or crate, and you want the dog to go in there on command. You don't want the dog just to rush in there when it wants to. You want to turn it into a command. Also, when you open the door, what do you do? What does the dog do? Does it come racing out?
She sniffs, and she'll use, like at night at least, she'll usually go in on her own accord.
But okay.
She really likes the area.
Good. When you open up the crate door, say she's got to go out to go to the bathroom, what happens when you open up the crate door? Does she come?
She's totally cold.
Okay, I don't want that, right? So, this is what you're going to do. I've got a great video on this, too. You're going to open up the door a little bit. As soon as she tries to come out, you close the door right into her. You're not going to hurt her. Close the door into her, right? Then you open up the door again. She might try it again. Close the door into her again. If she goes, ow! Don't worry about it. Your dog's going to be running into walls 10 times the speed. It's no big deal. I don't want the crate opening to mean anything. I want the dog to go, okay, there's a crate door open. And I want them to look at you and go, what would you like me to do? Ah, thank you for asking. I want you to come out. I want every little thing to be a command because this, remember, you're raising a dog, not a puppy. And how do you want your dog to be when it's older? For instance, you open up the front door. I want the dog to go, big deal, front door's open. Why would I leave until I was told? So all your thresholds are so, so, so important. Okay? I also want you to get a slip lead, a basic slip lead. They call them British slip leads. And that's going to be, the dog's going to wear that around the house, dragging around the house. Because if your dog, if you want to get your dog, Sarah, from point A to point B, I don't want you picking up the dog. And it's going to be hard because it's cute, right? I know it's cute and you want it to lick your face and all that stuff. But I go puppy gaga too, you know. But when I raise puppies, it's like four on the floor and you do what I tell you to do. That's
it's hard to do because they are so cute.
I know, but guess what? Are you a fan of my Facebook page?
Yes, I am.
Okay. How many of those dogs that you see pictures of are cute?
All of them.
And guess what?
Almost
half of them would love to bite you. Okay? And they will bite you to harm you. So we got to be careful about the cute factor. I agree 100% they're cute. But that doesn't give them a free pass for bad behavior, at least in my world. You should also be working on thresholds, which are going outside. Are you taking your dog to one spot to go potty, or are you letting them just run around to go to the bathroom?
We take her to one spot.
Good.
She's got her spots now kind of in the yard, where I know she'll probably go if she's in that spot.
Is she on a leash when she's doing this?
No.
Okay, I want her on a leash.
Okay.
Do you have a fenced-in backyard?
Yes.
Okay. So I don't want you just to open up the door and let her run free. I want her on a leash, the slip leash. You walk out to the exact same spot every time, right?
Okay.
You plant your feet, then you give her all the leash, like whatever, 6 feet of leash. And you just say whatever you want to say, go potty, go pee-pees, whatever you want. Don't move your feet. Don't let her drag you around to find the perfect spot. If she has to go, she'll go, right? So that's where she goes. And if she goes poop, I want you to leave at least one or two pieces of poop in that area for a little bit. Don't clean it all up.
Okay.
So then she'll know because she'll feel the scent. Even if you cleaned it up, the scent still stays there. But let's leave the poop there because what they do is they go over to it and they sniff it and they're like, oh, this is the poop spot. because I want, I don't know about you, but I like to take trips and I travel. I want to be able to stop somewhere because I don't use those, at the rest stops, I don't use those puppy pens. They're disgusting. So I want to be able to get my dog out of the car, walk over to a piece of grass, go potty, and then put my dog back in the car and then go. So I want my dog eventually to go to the bathroom on command, and I don't want it to be this big, huge event. No jumping, okay? This dog, if this dog puts its legs up on you, no affection. I know it's a corgi. It'll probably only be, 25 pounds tops, but still. I can't have dogs jumping because if it jumps on a child and knocks them over, the child screams, the dog bites. So okay. I think when I see puppies, I don't think today. I think a year from now.
Yeah, that's kind of like this where me and my husband differ because I don't want to have to use the strong collar. Like, I don't want to have to correct behavior. I want to introduce the behavior, have her always have the good behavior.
Well, okay, so you don't, this is the thing. Theoretically, you don't need to use any of these tools. If you get a puppy, the problem is I don't get many puppies. People hire me after they're older and they've already created bad habits.
Yeah.
But I also want you to know, Sarah, at some point, if you're not prepared to give that dog a good correction, you're going to eventually struggle. So I tell people, and when I talk about corrections, that doesn't mean I walk in the house and start beating my dog or yelling and screaming at my dog. But there's going to be a time, there's going to be a moment in time during that dog's life that you're going to have to say, you absolutely can't do that, and I don't want to have to repeat myself. So I really think every dog owner should be prepared at one point to correct a dog. Because remember, you can't stop a behavior by training another behavior.
Okay. So but the collar, not till 14 weeks.
Yeah, not till 14 weeks. Yeah. All right, that's a commercial break. I got to go. Keep staying in touch with me. Let me know next week what's going on, or please attend my Monday and Wednesday free webinars, okay? I want to follow your story. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you, 888-345-0790. Thank you. I want all my colleagues in the pet industry to make sure you have proper insurance coverage. You should be calling Mark Dorley at Dorley Insurance, 401-886-9600. Whether you're a veterinarian or a vet hospital, do you own a pet grooming salon, or are you a mobile groomer? Do you do dog training in a classroom, a board and train, on the road, or even in an animal shelter? You need proper insurance. This is very important for dog walkers, pet sitters, and at-home dog trainers. Do you have proper liability insurance and commercial vehicle insurance? I have seen so many of my colleagues in this industry not have the proper amount of insurance, and they've lost their business. Mark can also help you with mandatory workman's comp insurance and all of your auto, personal, and business insurance needs. Mark will sit down with you and customize an insurance plan for you and your business. I highly encourage you to give Mark Dorley at Dorley Insurance a call, 401-886-9600. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I want you to be able to purchase pet food seamlessly, and PetFlow.com, that's PetFlow.com, was founded for that simple reason. Searching and buying high-quality pet food should not be a pain. They have over 200 different brands: Taste of the Wild, Canada, Blue Buffalo, Origin, and that's just a few of them. PetFlow ships everything over $49 for free, and with warehouses in New Jersey and Las Vegas, they're going to ship to you in 2 to 5 days. But the real value is auto delivery. Mine is set up every 4 weeks, but from 2 weeks to 16 weeks, you can get your orders delivered to your door automatically. Real deal here, guys. 99% off a bunch of doorbuster deals. What I want you to do, petflow.com, type in Solid Canine, that's solid letter K, number 9, for 15% off your first order. Petflow.com.
Hey, Bob, how's business? Is the new website helping?
Not good. I can't figure out how to get the website finished.
How did you do it? Easy. I called web.com. They built my website for free.
Wow, free? Really? Web.com?
Yep, and in just 7 days. Then they promoted it on all the search engines.
Like Google, Yahoo, and Bing?
Exactly. And Web.com has helped grow my business so much, I had to bring on new staff.
Hey, if Web.com did it for you, they're perfect for me.
Web.com can build your website for free in as little as 7 days. If after 30 days you're happy with your website, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting support, and maintenance, all for just one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing. Call now 1-800-535-8815. That's 1-800-535-8815. Again, 1-800-535-8815. There is no upfront charge for building the website, after which the monthly fee applies. Rights to the website are relinquished upon cancellation unless otherwise purchased. Call now 1-800-535-8815.
Are you a dog owner looking for a local dog trainer? I'd like you to go to canineprofessionals.com. It's the home of the IACP, the International Association of Canine Professionals. A lot of people are asking me, is there a trainer in my neighborhood that's similar to you? Go to canineprofessionals.com and you can find one. If you're a dog trainer, I want you to be part of something that's bigger than you. I want you to join the International Association of Canine Professionals because they're for advocating for balanced training around the world. Thank you so much.
Water damage from frozen pipes at home or office? For immediate response and repair, call the local Rhode Island company, Lynch's Cleaning and Restoration, 464-8937. That's 464-8937. Immediate response, repairs, and total satisfaction.
Hey, everyone. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Every day on my Facebook page, people keep asking me, what are those dog beds that dogs keep doing place on? They're from Petcot. That's petcot.com. Four different sizes. You can use them inside and outside. You hose them down. You spray them down. They're easy to clean. They're raised up off the ground, which makes it more comfortable for the dog. Let's airflow underneath both for cold and warmer weather. They are fully assembled when they ship them to you. It's a great company, petcot.com. You will love them. Your dog will love them. Great for dog owners and dog trainers.
Heat of summer or winter cold, your comfort is our goal.
At Regan Heating and Air Conditioning, your comfort is our business. Generations of families and businesses in Rhode Island and southeastern Massachusetts trust their comfort and security to a local family-owned company with decades of experience satisfying residential and commercial customers with high-efficiency Lennox and ductless Mitsubishi air conditioning and heating systems that bring immediate savings to you. It's March, and though it's hard to imagine, summer is just around the corner, and that means it's preseason air conditioning sale time at Regan. Now save up to $2,500 in rebates on qualifying Lennox and Mitsubishi systems and ask about their 12-month interest-free financing. No ducks, Regan has high-efficiency energy.
Okay, we're coming back, and you're going to have about 12 minutes.
Approved National Grid Value Plus installer that can convert your costly oil system to clean and economical natural gas. Regan, Lennox, and Mitsubishi. Heating, cooling, generators. Call today, 401-461-8100 or ReganHVAC.com.
Your comfort is our business. Regan Heating and Air.
Now, more of What Would Jeff Do on AM 790. Call Jeff now at 437-5000 or 1-888-345-0790. What Would Jeff Do continues now on your station for talking business, AM 790.
Welcome back, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training with my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do, talking to you live this Saturday morning on AM 790. Talking business around the world on Solid Canine Training Radio. Give me a call at 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790. The last call was perfect. She emailed me a question. I told her to call the show. She took the effort to call the show.
She really wants help.
Yeah, and I will bend over backwards. I will bend over backwards.
I was just picturing you doing that.
Yeah, I'm telling you, if you don't make an effort, I'm sorry. I can't help you. If you make an effort, I am here for you. And anybody that attends my Monday and Wednesday webinars, and I usually break down in tears because of the success stories.
And then I get all disgusted.
Yeah. My Wednesday night webinar, one of my attendees is just about to get her one-year sober chip. And I'm one of her inspirations.
Don't start.
I'm not going to cry now because I'm in different mode of mind. I mean, it's incredible. We don't have time for me to read a testimony. I get so many testimonials. There's this incredible testimonial that I got yesterday. Maybe I'll read it. It's good information. I'll read it. I'll read it later. I'll read it at the top of the hour, after the break.
I almost got teary-eyed a couple minutes ago.
From what?
Lucy texted me some pictures of Clover opening her birthday present from Rory, and it's the cutest thing ever.
That's right. Clover's 10.
She's 10. Double digits,
baby. Double digits. Big 1-0.
Going to do a little shopping with her today.
Yeah, it's good. We know Super Target or Target.
We don't have Super Target here.
We don't?
No.
No, they're pretty.
It's too bad. It's awesome.
They're super. Oh, when we were on the RVing trip, we were.
Yeah.
I know. I'm getting the RV ready to go on the road. Oh, guys, RVDogTrainer.com. RVDogTrainer.com. I'm going to be out in Ohio. So if you're within 300 miles of Mansfield, Ohio, get your butt there. It's $200 a ticket. Come on. 2 days? 18 hours of dog training with me? Come on now. So, got it? Question.
Okay. They're coming in like crazy.
Good.
Let's see if I can keep up with these things. This one's from Gary. Hi, Jeff. I have been training my reactive Belgian Shepherd with an e-collar technologies educator.
Nice.
My question relates to the timing of the correction. For example, should the correction be made at the instant that my dog sees a distraction, or should I delay the correction to see how he is dealing with the distraction and then correct him as required?
All right. So, Gary, great question. I need some more specifics, but the way my corrections go is just like any other marker, a correction is a moment in time, right? So a correction is a moment in time that just like it's a marker, just like praise. So like saying good and no. Good is a moment in time when the dog does something proper. No is a moment in time when the dog does something improper. I'm a huge advocate of yes and no. So I'm a big advocate, especially if you've got a reactive dog, that correction should be extremely, extremely timely, right on the spot. So what I do is I spend more time on energy than the physical action of the dog. Does that make sense? So how many of you, if any of you have gone through rehab before and you're trying to get, let's use alcohol as an example, I really like to talk about the rehabilitation of dogs almost like drug and alcohol rehabilitation. So you're just starting to get into rehab, right? You're 3 months sober, all right? You still can't walk into a bar because you don't feel comfortable. Do you call your sponsor when you're in the bar? No. Do you call your sponsor when you're outside of the bar? No. Driving to the bar? No. You call your sponsor when you're at home thinking about getting in your car, going to the bar. Thinking about going to the liquor store or package store or packy, depending on where you live, that's when you call your sponsor. Does that make sense? At the moment in time you think about the inappropriate, dangerous behavior is when you give the correction. And I know this resonates with a lot of people because addiction is powerful. And I'm telling you, bad behavior in dogs is an addiction. And I rehab the dog the same way I would rehab, and I am no expert on addiction at all. But myself, some of my family members, we've struggled with drugs and alcohol. So all I can tell you is the thought is what you address. The thought is what you address. All right? I hope that helped. Was his name Gary?
Yes.
I hope that helped. And kudos to you for using a mini educator. I'm actually, after my Ohio seminar, I'm actually going to go out to see Greg at E-Collar Technologies.
That's awesome.
I just want the photo op.
No, that's terrible.
No, we're going to sit down. We're going to talk about new technology coming out.
I need a two-dog.
Oh, no, you're going to come out with?
Chihuahuas.
Maybe I'll come out with some, he's got some of those fancy covers. The lady educator. Yeah, we're going to come out. We'll do a nice photo op. And Diana's going to be with me. So make sure you prep her. Diana's going to be in the RV with me for 5 days. So you might want
to She's going to need to know all kinds of stuff. All kinds of stuff.
Earplugs, nose plugs.
Ugh. How to make your coffee properly or it gets thrown in her face.
No, I would. No. I drink inappropriately made coffee. Come on, you know me. You saw me today at Seven Stars.
I remember sometimes you used to get upset when people brought you coffee that wasn't proper.
Okay, that's a different story. It was at a trade show. That was a job requirement. Someone said, Jeff, do you want coffee? I specifically told them what I want, and they'd come back with the absolutely wrong thing. That's different. Anyway, let's go to another webinar question.
Sure.
Thank you.
This one's from Jody.
Hey, Jody.
I just adopted a 2-year-old pit mix. He is about 47 pounds. I'm looking at the prong collars on your website. Would you recommend the 2.25 or 3 millimeter?
That's a good question. So the thing about that is, you're right on the cusp. You got a pit bull mix, strong dog, no fur or minimal fur. You probably could get away with a 2.25 millimeter, but you might have to order extra links. Therefore, you're best off buying two of them and just sort of like using the second one for your links. Definitely a 3 millimeter will fit. You can always start with a 3 milliliter, and then once the training goes down, you can work into a 2.25, but I'm going to want you to eventually do remote collar training. We remote collar train every single dog, and this is the thing. Remote collars, guys, so Jody, to answer your question, both would work.
How would you decide, though? Would it be based on the behavior of the dog?
No.
Always just the weight?
The weight. Sometimes the weight and the neck size.
And the fur.
The neck size. So in other words, I wouldn't use a 2.25 on like a German Shepherd or a very furry dog because it just won't make contact. But I've never used anything over a 3 millimeter. In fact, I just. Did you see Diana and I editing last night?
Yeah.
We did some filming. I'm actually coming out with a brand new. This is going to be the industry standard of how to pick out and put on and work a Hermsprenger prong collar. So by the end of this weekend, I will have a finished video. It's going to be about a 20 to 25 minute video, way too long by industry standards, but it's a how-to video. You will know everything you need to know about prong collars. I'll be putting that out. And I bet you that video will be shared by hundreds of people because it will show you how to properly use a collar. So, Jody, I'm thinking you can probably get away with both. I wouldn't be surprised if I had that dog. I probably would, though, is get a 2.25, and I probably would need 3 or 4 extra links. So for that, you might as well buy 2 of them, all right? Which sort of sucks because you got to spend more money. I know. But it's worth the investment, I think. All right, thank you. If anybody else is on my webinar that wants to ask me questions, this is how you get your answers. All right, you can also call me up at 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790. You have another question?
I have an email question here.
Oh, cool.
This one's from Andrea.
Mm-hmm.
I have a small 4-month-old Shih Tzu. His last vaccines were just given and now is allowed to go outside. The last couple of weeks, he has been allowed to go out with no leash and collar.
Fool.
Now, this last weekend, I put his collar and leash on.
Yep.
However, when I start to walk the puppy, just stays put and doesn't want to move.
Yep.
I have my whole family call his name and get him excited to start walking, but it only lasts a couple of seconds.
Yep.
This goes back and forth and we get nowhere.
Yep.
He also chokes a lot with the collar, and I'm worried about all the tugging and pulling could damage its small, fragile neck.
It's only a five-pound dog. It will.
Now I'm not sure what to do, and I am stuck as to what to do. Is this a matter of just encouraging him to like walking in the leash as it needs?
I'm listening.
Yeah, I don't
know. Okay, you can stop. This is the thing. What's the person's name?
Andrea,
this is the thing. This is what I want you to do. Oh, shoot, we didn't make it.
What?
Diana, if you're listening, hon, we got to do come sit break. I'll make a video. This is what I want you to do. What's her name again? I'm sorry.
Andrea,
I want you to do this. What I want you to do. I want you to have that dog dragging a leash, a very, very thin leash, 1/4-inch nylon. Guys, don't use cotton leashes because cotton leashes get wet and they get moldy. Use a nylon leash, 1/4-inch. 4 to 6 foot long, maybe a 4 foot long, and attach that to either do a 1/4-inch slip lead or a very small collar, a thin collar. I want that dog to know what it feels like to have a collar on. Do not use a harness. Harnesses were made for pulling. You're not going to be able to train your dog. I want you to do a routine called here, sit, break. Here, sit, break. You're going to use food. The only way this dog eats is they come running to you. So what's the dog's name? Does it say?
No.
Good. So the dog's name is Lucy. It'll be Lucy, here, sit, and then you throw the food on the ground. So the dog comes. Remember, these aren't treats. If the dog wants to eat, the dog will have to run to you, sit, and then you break. Here, I do this with 8-week-old puppies. Here, sit, break. Here, sit, break. Here, sit, break. Over and over and over again. All this dog is going to do is what? Woohoo! Party time! Hey, Rick, what's up? And what they're going to do is their dog's going to come running to you, and they're going to sit in front of you because all dogs know how to sit when you take food and you put it up in the air, and then you say break, and you then just toss the food maybe, 6 inches away from the dog. The dog breaks and eats the food. While the dog is eating the food, guess what you're doing? You're walking 6 feet away. And then you go, do it again and again and again. And again, this dog is going to be bomb-proof, rock solid. That's how you start the dog. But getting the whole family to be all excited. What are you, freaking the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders? That's not what you need. You don't need that. One person at a time.
There's another question we'll have to address when we come back.
We have another hour of this.
Yes.
We have another hour of this.
Yes, and Jody says, thank you so much. Love your videos.
Okay, thank you. Brett, the weirdest thing. On the replay, when we put this up on YouTube, this song gets me kicked off.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But don't you guys own this song?
I don't know. It's in our database.
Yeah, so you own it.
Yeah, but probably then if you're using it on the video, there's probably some law
it's
there.
It's so weird. So we got to figure out a way to maybe...
switch the song.
No, or can we make it so this song is not heard on the replay? No.
No.
I know. It's like I'm a producer, not a magician, Jeff. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you guys. What would Jeff do? Show 888-345-0790. Let me say that again. 888-345-0790. Call in. There's 2,500 people listening to the show around the world. You got a freaking question? Call in. I'll give you an answer. Because if not, don't you dare complain about your badly behaved dog. We're coming right back. I got another hour. Oh, we got a caller. Look at that. Let me be your ruler. You can call me Queen Bee. Let me live that fantasy.
This is Amy from Moriarty's Fence, the Invisible Fence brand pet safety experts. The Invisible Fence brand works for all dogs, all breeds, all ages. We start training puppies as young as 10 to 12 weeks old, and we also keep pets safe at home, too. The key to our 27 years of success is our customer service and pet training support. Our installed outdoor safety solutions start as low as $7.99.
Yeah, see, once you go onto YouTube, you're no longer protected by
the
nails.
I know.
Yeah.
50808 for a free design and pet consultation visit. Or schedule online at moriartyspence.com. At Moriarty Spence, we work hard so you can rest easy knowing your pet is safe.
We own it now. And we're uploading it. So if you guys ever, cancel it.
Yeah, yeah. No, I know. You told me all this.
Oh, yeah. It worked out great. Except when you click it into the
Moriarty
Spence. Yeah.
225-0808, keeping pets safe since 1986. Moriarty's Fence reminds you to support your local shelter, adopt, volunteer, donate.
Hey everyone, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue in Providence. That's losandesri.com. Family-owned, family-run, the most incredible Peruvian and Bolivian food. They're open 7 days a week. Let me tell you how I start there. Okay, I get the ceviche martini. I get the calamari Bolivian style, and causa la mania is delicious. Linda, I know you love the entrees.
They have some awesome entrees. I love the envuelto de pollo. It is such a great dish. The bisteca andina, which is Peruvian-style steak. And they always have awesome specials, steaks grilled to perfection, and delicious fish dishes.
We love the specials. Sometimes we don't even get the menu. We just order off the specials menu.
That's true.
Desserts.
Oh.
Desserts. Dessert.
I love the in-house made tres leches cake. That is my favorite, and the flan is awesome, too.
Both homemade.
Mm.
Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue, losandesri.com.
It's your car. You take it to people you trust. It's your finances. You want to go to the experts.
We've got to find a way to get out from under this debt. We can help.
The National Foundation for Credit Counseling is a nonprofit organization that has been helping people for 60 years. Speak with a counselor today at 800-388-2227 or visit debtadvice.org. This is a public service campaign for the NFCC.
AM 790 is your station for talk and business with a powerful weekday lineup. From 6 to 10 a.m., it's the iconic Imus in the Morning program, followed by Chris Plant's unique take on politics. From noon till 3, it's the one and only Dennis Miller. Nighttime, it's money guru Dave Ramsey at 6, followed by Michael Savage and the Savage Nation at 9. Great shows and powerful personalities. It all starts weekday mornings at 6 with Imus on your station for talk and business. AM 790.
I'm Dr. Jackie Duncan, a clinician scientist working with the American Health Assistance Foundation to find a cure for macular degeneration, a debilitating eye disease. It's important to let young people know how to take care of their sight. Go to ahaf.org/kids, where families learn about macular degeneration using interactive games and stories. That's ahaf.org/kids, or call 1-800-437-2000. 2423 for free information and resources.
Congratulations to the Money Talk program for 25 years on the air. Don Zoa and his team have been sharing valuable financial insight with Southern New Englanders on what is now the state's longest-running financial talk show. Congratulations, Don Zoa, and thank you.
AM 790 Talkin' Business. I'm Miss in the Morning. Yankees Baseball. Great local business talk. WPRV Providence. A Cumulus station.
Nuclear deal. Co-pilot investigated. I'm John Trout. Only 4 days remain until the deadline for a preliminary nuclear deal with Iran. Negotiators in the Swiss town of Lausanne are settling in for another round of lengthy sessions today. Investigators continue to understand why the German wing's co-pilot crashed the Airbus into a mountain. Correspondent Fred Pleichen says a former girlfriend of Andreas Lubitz is providing new insight.
She described him as a very sensitive man, someone who needed a lot of care, a lot of attention, someone who could also be quite flattering. She was an airline stewardess herself on German wings as well, but she also said that he was someone who had a very dark side, someone who at night would wake up because he was having bad dreams, someone who would go into rages when they had fights.
Aaron Hernandez's fiance says the former NFL star was drunk the night Odin Lloyd was killed. At Hernandez's murder trial yesterday, Shania Jenkins testified she and Hernandez were drunk on vodka and cognac the night of the murder. I'm John Trout. There are new details in the government's desertion case against Army Sergeant Bo Bergdahl. Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr has the latest.
Bergdahl has told Army investigators he did not intend to desert, that his plan, his intention, was to walk to the next nearest Army outpost in eastern Afghanistan in July 2009, in the middle of Taliban country, that he was walking to that outpost to report what he thought, what he believed at the time, to be a lack of leadership, order, and discipline in his unit.
Bergdahl was charged this week with desertion and misbehavior before the enemy. Granite staters are looking forward to getting outside after a historic winter that hammered New England. Activities were on hold due to extremely cold and a snowy winter, but folks in Manchester, New Hampshire will make up for lost time. The St. Patrick's Day Parade will start shortly after noon today, rain or shine. I'm John Trout.
As an entrepreneur, you're always on the go. So turn your mobile phone into a business phone system with Grasshopper, the entrepreneur's phone system. Get a new business number or keep your current one. Sound professional with a main greeting and multiple extensions that forward callers to your mobile phone. You can even get voicemails transcribed. Join over 150,000 small businesses who stay connected with Grasshopper. See how it works at grasshopper.com, the entrepreneur's phone system.
My Bed Back loves Minecraft Matic.
My Bed Back loves Minecraft Matic bed. My Bed Back loves Minecraft Matic adjustable bed.
These aren't actors. They're real people who sleep better every night thanks to their Craft Matic adjustable bed. Just call 800-371-9576. That's 800-371-9576. For prices and free information on today's Craft Matic adjustable beds, call 800-371-9576. That's 800-371-9576.
Astronaut Scott Kelly now on board the International Space Station, which he'll call home for the next year. NASA will use Kelly's identical twin brother, Mark, to study the effects of space on aging. Senator Harry Reid of Nevada says he'll not seek re-election.
Reid spoke on Nevada's KNPR public radio station.
I want people to remember me from my first 34 years in Congress, not my last 6 years in Congress.
Harry Reid saying he didn't want to seem like the sports player who didn't know when to hang it up. He said the injury on a treadmill was not the reason, but gave him time to think. Reid has set his replacement process in motion, endorsing third-in-command Senator Chuck Schumer to be Dem leader over his number two, Dick Durbin of Illinois. Bob Costantini, Washington.
A record number of Californians are supporting legalizing pot. A Public Policy Institute of California poll finds 53% say marijuana should be legal, the highest since they began asking the question in 2010. I'm John Trout.
Listen and learn. This radio station,
2 minutes
around the world, free with the IR radio app. Listen to your favorite news and talk wherever you go. Plus, you can hear over 1,500 live and local stations. iHeartRadio.com.
Hi, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I'm so excited to talk to you about Freeway Car Wash. They have 4 locations in Rhode Island. They do interior and exterior as well as self-serve, but their detailing service is phenomenal. They have something called The Works. $18, but mention me, mention my name, my show. It is a $9 savings. Interior and exterior detailing. I took my dog van to them. Yes, my disgusting dog van. It came back to me better than I've ever seen. Freeway Car Wash, freewaycarwash.com. Hey guys, it's Jeff. I want to talk to you about peace of mind. There's one phone number that I keep in my phone. East Side Collision Center, 2050 Plainfield Pike, Cranston, Rhode Island, 401-490-9975. The peace of mind that I have, if I ever get into an accident, I can call them up, my truck will be towed to them, and I will get incredible service and repairs done to my vehicle. Eastside Collision Center, 30 years in business, family-owned, 401-490-9975.
AM 790 is your home for I Miss in the Morning, New York Yankees baseball, and great local and national talk. Check out the podcasts of your favorite AM 790 shows at 790business.com. I Miss in the Morning, New York Yankees baseball, and great local and national talk, all on AM 790 Talk and Business.
Freeway Laundry. Dirty clothes in, clean clothes out. Pick up and delivery. Oh, yeah, you heard me right. Pick up and delivery. And yes, I wrote that in all caps because I am shouting it. I don't even want to talk about their 4 convenient locations with self-serve and drop-off service, the comfy couches, the free Wi-Fi. Just go to freewaylaundry.com. You can learn about their locations, their hours, their prices. But let's not forget, free pickup and delivery. Go to freewaylaundry.com.
This is What Would Jeff Do? Canine Training with Jeff Gellman. Call Jeff now at 437-5000 or 1-888-345-0790. What Would Jeff Do? On your station for talking business, AM 790.
Welcome back, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, with my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning on AM 790, talking business around the world on Solid Canine Training Radio, 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790. Folks have started private email messaging me, how do I log into your Monday and Wednesday night webinars? Okay, this is the thing. It's the same login code every single time. So this Monday morning on my Facebook page, remember, everything is social media with me, all right? Everything is social media. So you'll see the login code for the webinar. Save that login code, and then you can actually pick which webinars you want to go to. It's a drop-down menu. So next week's, I already have Mondays and Wednesdays up, but it's going to be the same login code every week. They're from 9 p.m. to 100 minutes after that. And for folks that say, listen, I got people in the UK, in Germany, in Russia, in Australia, and obviously then in the United States that watch those webinars. We all can do it. Anyway, I've got Matt on the line from Wheelersburg, Ohio. Good morning, Matt.
Good morning, Jeff and Winnebago.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
Oh, it's Matt. Hey, Matt, how are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. I just saw this Matt from last weekend.
Oh, yeah. Hey, what's going on?
What's up?
Not much. I was just calling to give you guys a free plug on T3. What an amazing experience.
Oh, thank you. You did great. See, this is the thing, Matt. It's like, if you weren't to have been there, it wouldn't have been as great. And I'm serious. I'm serious. So what have you been doing?
It was an amazing group of people, and the community of people that are there to support and help afterwards are truly amazing.
Thank you. It's been great. It was great. It was great having you out here. It was great to meet you. We're so excited for the growth that I saw over the 5 days with you, and I'm just see where you're going to be 3 months, 6 months, a year from now, and you can keep coming back because they're inexpensive. And don't forget, I don't know how far you are from Richland County Fairgrounds in Ohio, but I'm going to be there in a couple of weeks, so. It's a 2-day seminar. You can bring one of your dogs with you or just hang out and do an audit. It's so inexpensive.
Okay, yeah. I seriously might try to make that.
All right, good. So you got back home safely, and what have you been doing?
Oh, I've been trying to catch up on everything at the house and plus try to tr- train the people within my household on how to some of the protocols that we need to run our dog through.
Right.
And then you know it's going to be a lot of personal development and you know trying to establish the criteria to establish the business within Ohio.
Right.
That's always the fun part.
Nice. Good for you. Good. Well, it's a great way to start, and thank you for calling in and talking about T3, and it's a wonderful, wonderful thing, and again, I'm so proud of you, and it was really great to meet you, and I can't wait to see you again.
Yes, exactly the same way. I feel the same way, and I can't wait to later on down the line attend another one.
Good. Thank you so much. All right, take care, Matt. So, Linda, let's go right to a webinar question. It's a three-part question. Let's go to the third. It seems like she wrote it in the first part is on the third, and then work your way up.
Okay.
From Melissa.
This is a comment rather than a question. Wow, I just literally logged onto this radio show, and Jeff mentions about my one-year sober chip. Hopefully I'm not so vain that he's talking about someone else.
No, it's about you.
And she says, eek! I like that. I almost started crying. Thank you for the praise, Jeff. Been working hard this week on getting enough sleep so I have less excuses, and so I am getting the walks in for Yuki and can get to doing drills while watching your webinars. I'm trying to make life changes here. Working the program is a great foundational piece in my life, but I got to keep growing. You have been a tool in my life recovery, Jeff. Yuki has been with me since the first time I tried getting sober. I have been wanting to give Yuki the life she deserves, healthy, no anxiety, listening to commands, and demonstrates happiness by obeying commands, and is calm. I'm rambling. I'm just so happy Candace introduced me to you.
Oh. And then she has two more comments.
I've realized the more I am brave in my life, the more I am brave with Yuki. You're inspiring me to be more brave. I'm doing something brave today at my job, and I'm watching you before I have to go in for inspiration.
Oh, that's so much.
That's nice.
Well, listen, I mean, look at it this way. Think about this. Now that you're not, like, now that you're sober and you're not drinking or doing drugs, think about all the free time you've got for dog training, right? Also, what I want you to do is I want to make sure that you download a bunch of stuff from audible.com. I personally like audiobooks, and I want to make sure that you've got you download them to your smartphone, and you put those earbuds in, and whenever you're driving, I want you to listen to that stuff. 5 to 10 minutes of Jim Rohn, Zig Ziglar, Tony Robbins, Jeff Olson. 5 to 10 minutes of that, even if you're taking a short trip, is going to dramatically change the way you look. What I also want you to stop doing is I want you to stop reading the news, watching the news. Got it? I want you to go through your Facebook feed, and any negative person, I want you to delete them, all right? Anything negative or toxic, delete, unfriend. You never want to see it again. All I want is positive things in your life, and that's not you ignoring things, right? But there's enough crud going around out there, but guess what? There's also tons of powerful happiness going around out there, all right? There's so much. Of course we've got war. Of course we've got death. I'm not ignorant to that. But guess what? We also have life. We also have success. We also have celebration. And that's how we do it. So proud of you, Alyssa. You go in strong. You go in powerful to that job. And you do what's best for you without any consideration of the company. And what I mean by that is this. If you're thinking about quitting your job, and a lot of people are like, oh, how are they going to survive without me? Listen. Not to be cold and uncaring, you ain't that important, okay? I'm not that important. So there's no, my job, my company, believe it or not, can probably survive without me. That's just the way it is. I've had so many people that have gone through T3, and they haven't. They're entry level, they're middle management, or they're at the top of their profession, and you know what? They've left their jobs, and the company still does fine. So don't worry about that. You go in and you do what's best for you. Because when it comes down to it, nobody cares about you but you. I care about you though. All right? And I want to know on Monday what happened, or on Wednesday what happened. And this is the woman who writes into my webinars that makes me cry every time because I'm so proud of her. I really am. All right. Great. You have any more email questions?
I do.
All right, let's go. 888-345-0790, 888-345-0790.
I have a 105-pound, 11-month-old lab German Shepherd mix. Mm. He loves being in the water more than life itself, and I am happy to oblige. However, my life must continue, and he has to be ready to come out of the water when I tell him. He is extremely obedient outside of the pool area and knows his basic commands. Currently, when I try to take him out, he swims away from me, and if I do get him out, he flops on his back so I can't walk him out by his collar.
Right.
The only option I have is to lift the behemoth and carry him outside the gate. I would love to let him swim as he pleases, but worry about him without supervision.
Right.
I want to be able to take him fishing with me, but I need to be able to get him out of the water
right.
when it's time to go.
Got it.
Help.
Okay. What's his name?
Will.
Will. First of all, kudos to you for swimming your dog. I train dogs to swim. All right? I would consider myself close to an expert on training dogs to swim. I've never met a dog that I couldn't train to swim. Everything from a Chihuahua, a bulldog, and then all your other swimming dogs. But I also want people to know they're not natural swimmers, because what happens with a lot of dogs is they don't use their back legs, therefore their whole front end, their butts sink to the bottom, and then they're splashing and going around in circles. Your dog first needs to know recall. Can you call your dog off leash out of the pool? In other words, just running around a field in the house. Because if you can't call your dog back to you out of the pool, how do you think you're going to be able to call your dog back to you in the pool? So every one of my dogs is remote collar trained. And guess what? Remote collars are fully waterproof. I suggest everybody go to e-collar technologies. That's ecollar.com. Everything from the 300 to the Boss, but your e-collar technologies mini educator 300 works on 90% of the dogs. They're fully immersible to like 30 meters. The handsets are floatable, which means they're also waterproof. I love swimming my dogs, but guess what? You come back when you tell them to. Got it? Okay. That's it. So,
that's it for that one.
Well, we'll continue after the break. I got more information. What's his name?
Oh, for Will?
Yeah, Will.
Will.
Will, more information after the break. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Give me a call, 888-345-0790. I'm madly in love with you. When I say that, I truly am. Anybody that takes the effort to write into my show, to call my show, to listen to my show, I am amazed that you're putting in the work. I am amazed, and I'm proud of you. Talk to you soon.
I want all my colleagues in the pet industry to make sure you have proper insurance coverage. You should be calling Mark Dorley at Dorley Insurance, 401-886-9600. Whether you're a veterinarian or a vet hospital, do you own a pet grooming salon, or are you a mobile groomer? Do you do dog training in a classroom, a boarding train, on the road, or even in an animal shelter? You need proper insurance. This is very important for dog walkers, pet sitters, and at-home dog trainers. Do you have proper liability insurance and commercial vehicle insurance? I have seen so many of my colleagues in this industry not have the proper or the proper amount of insurance, and they've lost their business. Mark can also help you with mandatory workman's comp insurance and all of your auto, personal, and business insurance needs. Mark will sit down with you and customize an insurance plan for you and your business. I highly encourage you to give Mark Dorley at Dorley Insurance a call, 401-886-9600. 9600. This is Jeff Gellman from Solid Canine Training. I want to talk to you about the folks at e-collar Technologies and the incredible products that they make. Many of you have seen my low-level remote collar training videos on YouTube, and I talk about low-level remote collar training on my radio show every week. Well, moving forward in 2014, e-collar Technologies and the Educator brand remotes will be my preferred brand in my board and train facility, as well as my 10,000 square foot training facility. The ease of use, the understanding for both the dog and the owner are very important to me. The way we train with our remotes is low level, pressure on, pressure off, and the folks at e-collar Technologies understand the needs of both the professional dog trainer as well as the average dog owner. Modern remote collar training does not involve shocking or zapping your dog at all. It is a low-level communication tool. It layers existing training with your dog so that your dog understands what you're asking for. If you're looking for the ultimate in high-level distraction, off-leash training, go to ecollar.com. Hi, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about the most exciting coffee house in Rhode Island, Seven Stars Bakery. They are local, handmade from scratch, award-winning morning pastries and bread, using local milk, local eggs, and lots of local produce. Locally roasted New Harvest coffee. Train baristas. They will make espresso for you that will knock your socks off. Whether you're meeting a friend for a delicious cup of coffee, some pastry, or grabbing a loaf of bread for dinner, you will not be disappointed. Family-owned and operated, three great locations, east side of Providence, west side of Providence, and in Rumford Center, Seven Stars Bakery. When it comes to local, they do it best. Hey everyone, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue in Providence. That's losandesri.com. Family-owned, family-run, the most incredible Peruvian and Bolivian food.
Back in 1 minute.
Let me tell you how I start there. Okay. I get the ceviche martini. I get the calamari Bolivian style. And causa la mania is delicious. Linda? I know you love the entrees.
They have some awesome entrees. I love the envuelto de pollo. It is such a great dish. The bisteca andina, which is Peruvian-style steak. And they always have awesome specials. Steaks grilled to perfection and delicious fish dishes.
We love the specials. Sometimes we don't even get the menu. We just order off the specials menu.
That's true.
Desserts.
Oh.
Desserts. Dessert.
I love the in-house made tres leches cake. That is my favorite, and the flan is awesome, too.
Both homemade. Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chalkstone Avenue, losandesri.com.
Water damage from frozen pipes at home or office? For immediate response and repair, call the local Rhode Island company, Lynch's Cleaning and Restoration, 464-8937. That's 464-8937. Immediate response, repairs, and total satisfaction.
Welcome back, Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training with my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning on AM 790. Talking business around the world on Solid Canine Training Radio. Linda, you saw, what was I going to talk about with Will? So what you're going to do is you're going to train your dog to have an off-leash recall out of the pool, and then in the pool, off-leash recall. Then what you'll do is you'll call your dog out of the pool, put him in a sit, put his leash on. I would just put a slip lead on, and then take him where you want. The bottom line is, you don't listen to me, you don't go in the pool. You don't listen to me, you don't go in the lake. You don't listen to me, you don't go in the ocean. It's non-negotiable. It's non-negotiable. So, and just keep in mind that I give this advice because I've trained a couple of thousand dogs, but for water work, over 500. So I've got a lot of experience doing this. I take dogs that not only don't know recall, but they don't know how to swim, and I train them to not only swim, but to come back on command out of the water.
We also, after the break, we were supposed to address another question.
Okay, louder.
Yep. About Andrea with the Shih Tzu.
Yes.
She says that she puts the dog out the back door to go to the bathroom, but should she be doing that on the walks instead of just letting the dog run free and poop wherever?
Yeah. No, this is what I want you to do, Andrea. So in my world, if she's got a back door and an outdoor place to pee and poo, dog on a leash, go to the same potty spot, stand there. The dog doesn't need to sniff every freaking tree, all right? I don't know about you. Men, maybe you've got a better experience with this. Guys, when you got to go, you go. You drop trowel and you go. Being a backpacker, I'm sorry. All my sports people, right? Triathlon, runner, trust me. You're a runner, Linda. You know this.
How many times
did you go while you were running?
Enough times.
Thank you. You're right. Thank you for your honesty on that. Being a triathlon, you don't stop. You just go. Poopy pants and all, you go. When you're at the level that I was at, you don't stop.
We didn't poop our pants.
Well, that's you.
That's disgusting. Okay.
Anyway, the point is,
I can't condone that.
I'm not saying to condone
it. I also can't condone peeing in the driveway.
Okay. What's wrong with peeing in the driveway?
There's a bathroom. How many bathrooms do we have? How many toilets do we have in our house?
Six. I want to bond
Plumbing's not free, Linda.
Okay. I want to bond. I like to bond with my dogs.
You do that when there's no dog out
but
there.
I go where the dogs go.
That's
and
despicable.
Guess it's not despicable because it gets hosed down and sanitized.
The area by the trash cans get hosed down and sanitized.
And sometimes they do when we power wash out the pool filters.
We should do a poll. Who thinks it's disgusting that Jeff pees outside wherever he feels like? I will, like an animal.
Monday, like an animal. Monday.
That has no. You might as well be like one of the chickens. The chickens just poop wherever. They don't even care.
When are we getting chicks, by the way?
When?
Yeah. What's the time?
I gotta order them.
Okay. So before our RV trip, how old were those chickens?
They were 5 years old.
5 years old. So right before our RV trip, we went away for 9 weeks. These chickens were not laying eggs anymore, so we had to do something with them. We gave them to a farm, a wonderful farm. So now it's time for chicks again, because we were getting, what, a dozen to 18 eggs a day?
No. We would get one egg a day from each chicken, pretty much. And we only had...
Why do we give away so many eggs to my staff, then?
Because we couldn't eat them all.
Oh. You were giving away dozens to my staff.
I would give a dozen a week away.
That's it?
Yes.
Oh, it seemed like a lot more. Time flies when I'm married and having fun. So
if you weren't so busy peeing in the driveway, you'd know how many eggs there were.
Hey. Okay?
Brett is so right.
Okay, we don't need you, Brett. Go to New York and watch a sports team. Okay? All right?
That's so rude.
No, it's not.
I know it comes from a loving place.
Okay. So this is what I want you to do with your dog. You go outside, dog on a leash. Hold on, I got to sneeze. No, I don't. I might have to sneeze in the middle of this question. You go outside. Dog on a leash, you go to the same potty spot every time. You stand there, plant your feet. The dog's got 6 feet of leash. 6 feet of leash around your body. Okay, who's good at math here, right? 6 foot circumference, 3.14. That's 18. 6 times 0.14, that's 60, 84. 18.84 square feet of space to do what? To go to the bathroom. More than enough. There is more than enough square footage for you to go to the bathroom.
Your math skills blow my mind.
Why?
I can't do that. Blah, 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 blah. Boom. Answer. What?
It's a math. You just see, don't you see the numbers in the air?
No.
You don't?
No, but Clover and Romy do.
I see numbers in the air, and I just move them around.
No, I can't.
Are you serious? You know, whenever I do math, I literally see the numbers floating in the air, and I can move them around with my mind where they're supposed to go, and then the answer comes up.
Yeah, no.
Oh, I don't see the answer in the air. I see the answer in my head, but I can see how the equation. You don't do that? Oh, maybe is that a skill? I've always done that ever since I was a kid.
I do the same thing.
Yeah.
Huh.
Okay, anyway. So you go to potty. But if your dog wants to go to the bathroom on the walk, that's fine. What I don't like is I don't like dogs sniffing on the walk. To me, the walk is work. It's time to work.
So it's your choice if you want the dog to pee or not, right? Like you pull over and you tell them to go potty. And
yeah.
If they don't go, you keep walking.
You can do that on the walk every once in a while if you want to just do that. But this concept of a dog sniffing the whole sidewalk and sniffing all these trees, no. I don't got time on my hands for that nonsense. I got places to be. I want to walk. Boom. We walk. That answered the question, right? Go to Lauren. Lauren's got a webinar question. Thanks, Lauren, for checking in.
Hi, Jeff and Linda.
Hello.
I can't stop coughing. How do you find the correct tightness of the e-collar, both on the regular collar it comes on and the bungee buckle one? Thank you.
So I like the bungee buckle. Does she have the bungee buckle?
I don't know.
Okay. So if you've got...
Lauren, do you have the bungee buckle?
Yeah, she does. Okay. Well, she's asking about it. So I recommend the bungee buckle. This is the thing. With a bungee buckle, you can make it snugger because then it can expand a little bit. The bungee buckle one from eCollar Technologies is a wonderful strap that you can use for your existing collar. What I like it to be, it should be very snug. The reason why you want your eCollar snug is because you want to make sure you don't get a false read. Okay? You want to make sure you don't get a false read on your collars. So that's really, really important. So I like them more snug than not. If you can take the box, and if you move the box and you try to move it around the dog's head, and if the box moves, it's too loose. So you want to make sure it's like nice and smooth. Okay, Lauren, you've got both. I would go with the bungee buckle one. I like the bungee buckle one the best. All right, I hope that answers your question. Linda, I just emailed you a question. It's a long one, so you might want to shorten it down.
No, I'll just read it.
All right, read it.
It's not that bad.
Okay, good.
Jeff, first off, thank you so much for all the wonderful content you have provided on your YouTube and your webpage.
Oh, you're welcome.
I spent a few hours researching your guidance, but have not found much on barking control. I have a male Great Pyrenees, and he likes to bark a lot, all the time. He barks when I leave the house, leave the room. He hears something, sees something, or many times for no reason at all, I think boredom. He will simply stand in the middle of a room and bark. This is just a loud, persistent, strong bark. I try playing with him, but he gets very lazy and has no reaction to toys. He just lays around and barks. He doesn't get excited unless he's outside reacting to something, but I understand from your videos how to work on that. The problem is inside. I've been using the command quiet for about a year now with mixed results. I put my index finger to my mouth like a signal and then say quiet. I try telling him to go to his place, and then he will go and then continue to bark. I've tried lay down, which distracts him for a few seconds.
No, you're not correcting it.
And then he continues barking while laying
down. That's annoying.
I have thought maybe he wanted attention or my presence, and he thinks the barking is getting that. So I've tried leaving the room to communicate that barking will not get him what he wants, and I give up waiting for him to stop after about 30 minutes.
Who's got time for that?
It takes 30 minutes.
You gotta be kidding. What's your name?
I just cannot seem just hold it to hold on, Jeffrey, to establish leadership.
Christina from Kansas.
Christina from Kansas. Yeah. I also believe he barks throughout the day while I am not home.
Right.
I am afraid the lack of correction all day reinforces
Of course it does.
I just need some peace in my house. Any advice is greatly appreciated.
Times.
Christina from Kansas.
Christina, remote collar train that dog. Bark collar train that dog. The dog barks, you say no, you give it a correction. That's what you do. It's like, you got to be kidding me. Like, shut up already. I don't want to listen to you. You know, you don't need your dog to bark. So that's what I would do. Remote collar. Your dog is barking for attention. Your dog is barking for manipulation. Properly remote collar train that dog. The dog barks. Correct. Dog barks. Correct. Dog doesn't show up. Correct higher. Shut up. Correct higher. That's not what I use remote collars for exclusively. I use it in the low levels as well. But for barking, you got to be freaking kidding me. Shut up already. I got things to do. I need peace in my home, and you're bothering me. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, my weekly call-in radio show. What would Jeff do? 888-345-0790.
My name is Jeremy Majors, Josh Donahue,
Jean Frederick,
Amy Phelps,
and my name is Audrey Bartolomeo, and I am a Train the Trainers alumni.
Before I attended Train the Trainers, I was just dabbling a little bit in dog training.
I was making about $120 a week with dog training, waiting tables.
I was working a full-time sales job.
I was a flight attendant.
I was working at Walmart, feeling pretty lost.
Just consistently going through these phases of general depression because I didn't really know how to make the dreams that I had a reality.
It's been about 6 months since I attended Train the Trainers, and now I'm doing great.
It's been about 2 months. Now I'm just doing dog training full-time, and it's all due to T3.
It has been 8 months. I now train dogs and change lives full-time, and I couldn't be happier.
It's been less than a year. Now I'm training dogs full-time, making about $12,000 a month, more than I used to make in a year in my last job.
I'm building a successful business, doing what I love.
If you've always dreamed of being in control of your life, waking up, working dogs on a daily basis, invest in this.
I am so proud to be part of the T3 family.
It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I want you to be able to purchase pet food seamlessly, and PetFlow.com, that's PetFlow.com, was founded for that simple reason. Searching and buying high-quality pet food should not be a pain. They have over 200 different brands. Taste of the Wild, Kennedy, Blue Buffalo, Origin, and that's just a few of them. PetFlow ships everything over $49 for free. And with warehouses in New Jersey and Las Vegas, they're going to ship to you in 2 to 5 days. But the real value is auto delivery. Mine is set up every 4 weeks. But from 2 weeks to 16 weeks, you can get your orders delivered to your door automatically. Real deal here, guys. 99% off a bunch of doorbuster deals. What I want you to do, PetFlow.com, type in Solid Canine, that's solid letter K, number 9, for 15% off your first order. PetFlow.com.
Hey, Bob, how's business? Is the new website helping?
Back after this.
Figure out how to get the website finished. How did you do it? Easy. I called web.com. They built my website for free, then they promoted it on all the search engines.
Like Google, Yahoo, and Bing?
Exactly. And web.com has helped grow my business so much, I had to bring on new staff.
Hey, if web.com did it for you, they're perfect for me.
Call now, 1-800-535-8815. That's 1-800-535-8815. Again, 1-800-535-8815.
Now more of What Would Jeff Do on AM 790. Call Jeff now at 437-5000 or 1-888-345-0790. What Would Jeff Do continues now on your station for talk and business, AM 790.
I like that song, too. Welcome back. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, my weekly call-in radio show, What Would Jeff Do? Talking to you live this Saturday morning, AM 790, live in the studio. I'll be in the studio this week. I'll be in the studio next week. After that, I'm going to be in Ohio, and then I'm back in the studio, and then I'm going to go over to Germany. So if anybody wants to hire me in Germany, I'm going to be, I don't know, about 60 kilometers from, maybe not even 60 kilometers, maybe about 45 kilometers southwest of Mannheim, and very reasonable rates because I'm already over there. I can help you with any of your behavioral issues. I'm doing private one-on-one training, and I don't know, maybe I'll rent a Porsche or an Audi and go see people just for the fun of it.
Hit up the Autobahn.
Well, I've been on the Autobahn before. Yeah, it was because I used to go to Germany all the time for work.
That's right.
And I was going, oh my God, I was doing 180 kilometers an hour, and I was going slow.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't like driving fast particularly, but I still think that'd be really cool.
It is fun. It's really fun. And I rented an Audi. And number one, it was a standard, and I love standards. And was it so much fun. And I stayed in this little village right out of Nuremberg, about 60 kilometers. I stayed out far away just so I could take the Autobahn into the convention. And I stayed in this little village outside of Nuremberg. And, you know, I've been to Germany a lot, and everybody speaks English. But this little village, nobody spoke English. And I stayed above the butcher shop. It was a butcher shop and a restaurant, and then above it was some rooms. So then every day I went downstairs, I got my meals, and I got to practice my German, which is a language I'd love to be able to. I mean, you can order food, right? I know I can ask where the bathroom is. I can order food, and I can say, you know, what is this and how much? And that's about.
Well, I was going to say, you used to have the, I don't know if you still have them, we had them here at the radio station, the promotional magnets you had with all the dog German dog commands.
Yeah, I know. That was a long time ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that was like a calendar. No, it wasn't a calendar. You're right. That was the commands. Got a caller on the line. I got Ron in Pawtucket. Good morning, Ron.
Morning, Jeff. How are you?
Fantastic. What's going on?
Well, I got a year and a half old Corgi.
All right.
Pretty good dog. Pretty smart.
Yes.
The problem is we're having a problem when he comes into the, when we're doing something in the kitchen.
Yes.
Specifically using the can opener.
Yes.
He loses his mind.
Yeah.
Grabs his true toy and violently throws it around and shakes it with his head.
Yeah.
And it's the can opener. It's even a hand can opener.
Right.
That doesn't make any noise. The Reynolds wrap, the silverware drawer. To the point where my wife was opening the can, they jumped up and bit her.
Wow, that's not good. Do you feed him raw? Do you feed him canned food or do you feed him dry kibble?
Dry kibble.
All right. So this is what we're going to do. First of all, the dog can't do that. That's not allowed.
Right.
But we want to do you've listened to my show before, Ron?
I follow you on the internet, and the problem is I work Saturday morning. Usually I happen to be off this Saturday, so that's why I'm calling today.
All right, so you follow me. So this is two things we have to do. We got to teach the dog yes and no, right? So
right.
We got to – this is what we're going to do. We are going to correct. First of all, he's biting your wife because he's can't handle the excitement. So he can't bite your wife even if he was out of his mind. He can't bite your wife.
Right.
But the reason why he's doing it, though, the same energy that he's using to grab that toy and shake it is the same energy he's using to bite your wife.
Okay.
So it's not allowed. So those are symptoms of lack of energy and impulse control. So the first thing we've got to do is, what do you want him to do instead? And what I would want him to do is, number one, I don't like dogs in my kitchen. So even if you've got an open floor pan with a living room kitchen set up, what I want is I want the dog to go to a dog bed off to the side. So that's where we do the place command. So if you're not familiar with a place command, it's the dog goes to a little bed, hangs out. I got a video on that, how to train it with remote training or with leash training. So you're gonna teach the dog that, and you can keep a leash on him. I would keep a leash on him for safety and security until the dog knows the command.
Okay.
Second of all, you've got to correct that behavior. So it's don't do this, which is a pretty strong conversation because he's biting, but do this instead. I would start with, okay, what's the least distraction that he triggered? Like, I'm not the least. So is he intense with a can opener, the manual one, as he is with the electric one?
Yeah.
Just as intense.
Yeah, right. He goes to another level.
Okay. So what you've got to do is you've got to correct that. You've got to correct it hard. So pretty much it's shut up, and now I want you to do this. Because if you whisper to him to shut up, he's going to blow right through it.
Right.
So it's got to be firm. So I would suggest prong collar and leash.
I have a prong collar.
Good. Does he know the place command? Have you done any training with obedience at all?
None.
Okay. Well, Rob, what the heck do you expect then?
Well, I mean, he knows how to sit.
Okay.
And, you know, and he listens to a pet, but as soon as he goes into this little place of his, it's like he's not even listening.
I know. It's like a guy in a bar who's on drugs. You're trying to rationalize with him. You can't. You throw him in jail, and the next morning you have a conversation. It's the same thing. So.
Right. Okay.
So what you've got to do is first we do the obedience. Okay. Place. Go watch my video on the place command. Place. Okay. If this dog breaks place without those kitchen distractions, what do you think he's going to do with the kitchen distractions? So first you got to do place. And then you start adding smaller distractions, like walking into the kitchen. I wouldn't be surprised if when you walk in the kitchen, he starts to explode. Then you reinforce the correction going back to place. Then when you add the high-level distraction, you're going to have a pretty strong conversation with this dog where it's going to be no, strong leash pop, and then you bring him back to place. But you might want to muzzle him up first so he doesn't redirect on you.
Okay.
Because if he's biting your wife, unless you want to, like, get divorced, which don't stop him from that, it's a good way to get her out of the house. But if you want to stay married, what I would do is we got to fix that because that's dangerous. And God forbid a child walk by at the same time that he'd go after the kid. Not because he wants to bite the kid. He's got to bite something. So
right.
he can't control his energy. It's like somebody that like punches a wall because they can't deal with stress.
Yep.
So it's the same mindset. It's like, listen, you got to learn how to deal with this stuff because it's a fact of life. I'm using my can opener whenever I want. I'm not going to ask permission. Teach him place, teach him no, reinforce place, add the distractions in, low-level distractions, increase to high distractions, and then you're going to get where you want.
Okay.
All right, try that.
Worth a try.
And I really, really appreciate you calling in. And
thank you.
Keep me up to date. I got those Monday and Wednesday night webinars at 9 p.m. You can't talk to me, but you can type to me, and you can watch me, and you can ask the question. So
okay.
that would be great. All right, thank you.
Fantastic.
Ron. Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
It was Ron in Pawtucket. That's what it is. That's a good example of a dog not – so this is the thing. Here's a great example where some people would be like the dog's freaking out and they would give them an obedience command. Like no, not even no, sit, place. You don't give a dog an obedience command when it's in high drive. You don't do that. You give the dog a correction when it's in high drive because they're not going to listen to the command. They won't listen to the command at all. So you've got to let the dog know, nope, you're not allowed to do this. So it's this concept of shut up. Now I'll tell you what to do. Does that make sense, guys? Good. Lynn, you got a question for me?
I have some Facebook questions. This one's from Caitlin.
Oh, thank you, Caitlin.
Hi, Jeff. During Wednesday's webinar, you outlined how to use an e-collar to extinguish our dog's sock-eating
habit. Oh, my gosh.
If he also enjoys eating other non-food items secondary to socks, should we repeat this protocol with each item? How far apart should we space the high-level avoidance sessions so as not to overstress our dog?
Okay. So this is a dog that is eating socks and getting surgery, and if I recall, she's paid $2,200 for the surgery. Okay. Frankly, what's her name?
Caitlin.
Frankly, Caitlin, I don't care about stressing out your dog. I assure you, that surgery is stressing out your dog 10 times more than I would stress out your dog. And I don't know what your bank account looks like, but having to pay $2,200 for surgery, that would stress me out. So let's forget the dog's comfort level right now, and let's worry about our bank account and the life and death of our dog. So what I would do is this. If the socks, and this is what I did. If people are not familiar about this because they don't listen to my webinars, which you really should, this dog eats socks. $2,200 for surgery. The dog could die. It's very uncomfortable. And guess what? After spending $2,200 and 2 weeks recovery and having your gut sliced open with a very sharp scalpel, the dog never learns not to eat the socks. So what I do is this. Remote collar on. She's got the Dogtron 1900, which is a pretty powerful remote. Turn it all the way up. I'm talking to 127. All right? Remember, guys, I use remote collars for low-level obedience, but we also can use it for high-level corrections. Sock eating is life and death. Bottom line, sock eating is life or death. I don't care what anybody tells me about how mean that is. Bull hockey. All right? You want to take your dog in for surgery for $2,200 and it might die on the table? Good for you, you uncaring, selfish dog owner. For me, no way. I want it fixed, and I want it fixed now. So, remote collar on the dog, sock on the ground, leave the room, dog goes over to the sock, hit that remote, high level, a count of three. One, two, three. Does the dog scream? Absolutely it screams. Does it hurt? It sure does. Guess what? Your dog ain't eating socks anymore. So, what else does your dog eat? Gets into the trash, eats poop, feminine products, same thing. You do it over and over and over again. So yes, as far as spacing it out, you tell me. Let the dog decide. Terry's on the line. We have time before the break. Terry from Atlanta, Georgia. Hey, Terry.
Hey, Jeff. I have a follow-up to the Windfish webinar question I had.
Yes.
I've mentioned my American Bulldog Bell.
Yes.
Which I said was perfect. You know, I remember that.
Yeah, that's why you're asking me. That's why you're asking me questions on the webinar, right?
You have. Belle is I say she's off-leash trained.
Right.
I'm kind of thank you for what you said. She's not, because you just put her back on a leash.
Right.
She does wonderfully. If there wasn't another dog in the world, she would be perfect.
Oh, right.
She does
right.
Everything I ask her off-leash,
right.
Regardless of what it is. But when around other dogs, or I see another dog approaching, I'll put her back on her leash.
Good.
Because I want to make sure she's safe and other dogs are safe.
That's smart.
But where the conversation kind of ended, because it's the webinar, which we have to type really quick. Is you said put her back on the leash and leave her on the leash. So that was confusing to me, because I don't know if you meant all the time, or what should I do at this point with her if she's still reactive to dogs. Obviously, I have to have her on a leash then, but what about all the other times that she's not? Because it sounded like you just wanted her back on a leash.
Okay,
period.
So Terry, well, thanks for calling in. See, this is the thing about the radio show, is we can go back and forth and I can ask you more questions. Okay. So first of all, you're in Atlanta. You have a great airport. I love your airport.
That's the best.
I love those rocking chairs. I mean, that's probably the best airport I've ever been in, is the Atlanta, Georgia airport. The restaurant selection, the rocking chairs, I love it there.
I can eat, drink, and shop.
That's right.
That makes it 100% good.
All right.
Yes, Linda.
Okay. So what I mean is this. Your dog is never going to learn how to behave off-leash around other dogs until you set up proper training protocols, all right? So what I want you to do is you've got to find dogs to work around. So that's with maybe someone that you know. Personally, if I had a dog-reactive dog that was good off-leash but not good good without dogs but not good around other dogs, unless I'm going to a place where there's never any dogs, which is impossible, I'd have that dog on a leash. So what you could do is you'd have that dog on a long line. Take a 50-foot long line, attach it to the dog, and work the dog off leash. But then what I want you to do is when you see another dog, I want you to use that remote to get the dog back to you. Are you remote collar training your dog?
Oh, yeah, I can put her 2 football fields away from me, Jeff, and put her in a down, and I can go talk to somebody 15 minutes, and she just watches me, and she's not back on the hill, and she'll stay there until I stay here. She'll come running to me as quick as she can. She has degenerative joint disease, so it's not always really quick, and she'll come running to me and go around me to the back and sit on my left side. She'll do that. So, yeah, she's extremely well-trained on everything, and I do put a long lead on her. We go to the park. We're playing ball. When it's time for her to play, we train and we play. When it's playtime, she's on a big, long stick at leash. She runs and play. She's never gone from that position to go try to attack a dog that she sees, 60, 70 feet away.
Right.
50 feet away. She doesn't do that. She'll continue to play. The dog gets within 30 feet, 25 feet. Story might change.
So what you need to do then is this. You got to work her around dogs starting at 50 feet away, and then 40 feet away, and then 30 feet away, and then 20 feet away, and then 10 feet away. You got to work on your obedience commands with your remote running her through. So instead of waiting till somebody comes, be proactive and find, and you have to, Terry, set up that situation, because the dog will never learn if you're just, if you're not setting up the training protocol in the bad behavior situation that you're dealing with. So all you're doing now is you're just doing avoidance training. And avoidance training is, that's fine, but the dog will never learn how to properly behave. So
is that the same thing I'm doing, Jeff, when I take her? Now, I don't, you know, I'm very careful around the people's dogs. Obviously, it's my responsibility to be with Mel.
Excellent.
But the thing is, I will take her where there's actually a fence between the dog park.
Good.
Don't put her inside, never put her inside the fence.
Never.
Area,
never.
But she will be in a down, say, 10 feet from the fence, and, she will lay there, and she doesn't really react to those dogs except on rare occasion. And she's not 10 or 15 feet away. You know, very rarely does she do that. And so I would assume that my next step is putting her with other dogs or closer to other dogs than even that.
Yeah, why don't you give, you know what I want you to do? Look up Josh Donahue. Josh Donahue. Just look on his name on Facebook. Or Google his name. He's down in Atlanta. He'll help you set up training scenarios, all right, that you can get over this.
Okay.
All right?
Because with some good stable dogs is what she needs to be around, and hopefully that will set her up to succeed.
Right. Or
react.
Or unbalanced dogs. So this is the thing, Terry. We don't live in a world with stable dogs. So at first...
No.
At first, he'll use stable dogs, and then we'll throw some dogs in there that are not stable. Because you know what? Our dogs have to learn to live with unstable dogs as well. So that's what I would do.
Do you think also, just as I mentioned, she had degenerative joint disease, do you think this could be a situation where because she is on medication for that, so she does have some pain with it. You think that in her brain, she's also not comfortable with dogs being close because of her being able to...
It could be, because if a dog comes up to her and wants to play with her, it might be uncomfortable. But I'm going to call this behavior not medical, all right?
Okay.
Let's not use, no disrespect to the joint disease, but I got a feeling this is more behavioral than medical.
Well, I just need to get her closer to some good, stable dogs.
Bingo.
I'm 10, 15 feet away now with a fence between us, and I will say good 95% of the time she just lays there.
Good.
She doesn't get up and move, but occasionally she will. And I'm telling you, that's the hard part for me is when she does, I'm watching her, paying attention to her 100% of the time, and she'll be in the down. Her eyes will be almost closed. The next thing I know, Jeff, she's up heading for the dog, and it's like, what triggered that? And such a
That's why you got to go to Josh and find out. But I'll be down in Gainesville, Florida. I know it's a little bit of a drive. But I get people from Atlanta that go to that seminar, so that's another option down in Gainesville. I know it's a big drive, but it's a weekend seminar, and also we can set up this scenario over and over and over again, and that's coming up in a month or two if you go to my RV dog trainer website.
Yeah, I saw that, and I was considering that, but it is a good drive for us, but it's not something that I would say I definitely wouldn't do, because I have to do something at this point. I've done everything else that I could possibly think of doing with her. And let me just say, these people that you say it's $200, it's only $200 to bring your dog to see me. I'm like going, these people are crazy. if you're an hour or two away from someone, they don't get $200. They're nuts. I would spend $200 in a heartbeat.
I know.
An hour away from
It's actually $325 with a dog for the Gainesville. But still, you're right. I mean, people spend that much money on a dog trainer and get no results. You spend the weekend with me and your life will change. So look at all that. We're going to a commercial break. Thanks for calling in, Terry.
Thank you so much, Jeff. I appreciate you.
We're not going to a commercial break.
The show's over in 2 minutes.
Oh, the show's over in 2 minutes. Oh, my gosh. All right. We're done. All right. Thank you, Terry. Are you kidding me? The show went over already? What a quick show. Oh, my gosh. That was fantastic. So, Linda, any last words at all?
Not really.
Nothing at all to tell the audience?
I love you all.
So Linda's got a new company that we can't mention on the air, but what you can do is if you go to my radio show page, it'll be up, a link will be up to her probably pretty soon. So as well as on the newsletter that we send out. And on Monday and Wednesday webinars, you'll be able to see me more if you're not on my Monday and Wednesday webinar. Oh, my gosh, it's so life-changing. And all this is done is through social media, so there's a lot of wonderful stuff. I can't say I'm proud of all you folks for participating in this webinar. Madly in love with you. And Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, the weekly call-in radio show. What would Jeff do? Talking July this Saturday morning at AM 790, talking business. Geez, this show went by fast.
Do you know when you say, what would Jeff do?
What would Jeff
every
do?
Single time I jump.
What would
I
Jeff
know
do?
You're going to say it.
What would Jeff do? Madly in love with you guys. Let's hug our kids. Let's train our dog. And now is the best time in the world to kick major butt. If you're ever thinking about a job change, career change, life change, relationship change, now we are at such a great opportunity for change, folks.
Hustle.
It's scary. Remember, the other side of fear is success. Every day I fail. Every day I'm afraid. And guess what? I use that to motivate me, not to bring me down. I love you guys.
This is Amy from Moriarty's Fence, the Invisible Fence brand pet safety experts. The Invisible Fence brand works for all dogs, all breeds, all ages. We start training puppies as young as 10 to 12 weeks old, and we also keep cats safe at home, too. The key to our 27 years of success is our customer service and pet training support. Our installed outdoor safety solutions start as low as $7.99 and can be customized for your property. Call 800-225-0808 for a free design and pet consultation visit, or schedule online at MoriartysFence.com. At Moriarty's Fence, we work hard so you can rest easy knowing your pet is safe at home. Moriarty's Fence, 800-225-0808, keeping pets safe since 1986. Moriarty's Fence reminds you to support your local shelter, adopt, volunteer, donate.
Are you a dog owner looking for a local dog trainer? I'd like you to go to canineprofessionals.com. It's the home of the IACP, the International Association of Canine Professionals. A lot of people are asking me, is there a trainer in my neighborhood that's similar to you? Go to canineprofessionals.com and you can find one. If you're a dog trainer, I want you to be part of something that's bigger than you. I want you to join the International Association of Canine Professionals because they're for advocating for balanced training around the world. Thank you so much. Hey, everyone. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Every day on my Facebook page, people keep asking me, what are those dog beds that dogs keep doing place on? They're from Petcot. That's petcot.com. Four different sizes. You can use them inside and outside. You hose them down. You spray them down. They're easy to clean. They're raised up off the ground, which makes it more comfortable for the dog. Let's airflow underneath both for cold and warmer weather. They are fully assembled when they ship them to you. It's a great company, petcot.com. You will love them. Your dog will love them. Great for dog owners and dog trainers.
Firearm enthusiasts, if you are not buying your firearms and supplies at Competition Shooting Supplies, then it's time to come in and talk to the owner, John, who will show you a large selection of new and used guns, including Glock, Sig Arms, Beretta, Ruger, and Smith & Wesson. Trade-ins are always welcome. And blue card test also taken here. Open Tuesday through Thursday, 9:30 a.m. to 6 p.m., Fridays, 9:30 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., 727-1716. 435 Benefit Street in Pawtucket. Competition Shooting Supplies. Your best choice for all your firearm needs.
Water damage from frozen pipes at home or office? For immediate response and repair, call the local Rhode Island company, Lynch's Cleaning and Restoration. 464-8937. That's 464-8937. Immediate response, repairs, and total satisfaction.
Hey, everyone. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Let me talk to you about Los Andes Restaurant. 90...
Monday. No, it's my staff. So I can take my staff out.
Delicious fish.
of the special. Sometimes we don't even get the menu. We just order off the special menu.
That's true.
Desserts.
Oh.
Desserts. Dessert.
I love the in-house made translate cheese cake. That is my favorite. And the flan is awesome, too.
Both homemade. Los Andes Restaurant, 903 Chuckson Avenue. Los Andes, RI.com.
Meg O'Rourke here. Listen to Diet Busters Thursdays from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. on AM 790. This week, we'll be talking about powdered alcohol, now legal in the United States. Which protein powder can help you lose weight but keep your muscle? And 10 food facts about food we eat. Listen in to Diet Busters Thursdays from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. on AM 790, your station for talk and business.
It's been called shell shock, war neurosis, and battle disease. Today, we call it post-traumatic stress disorder, and it affects one out of every five warriors in the battle in Iraq. The Wounded Warrior Project offers comfort and support for warriors with PTSD and all other scars of war, whether those scars are physical.
Something we've been going over
one. Find out how to help, because warriors are